As Director of Joint Operations, I manage and oversees all our missions and operations with the Dutch Armed Forces. I focus on three things. First of all, the protection of Dutch and Allied territory. Secondly, our contribution to peace, security and stability around the world, and especially focusing on peacekeeping operations. And the third part is assistance to our civil authorities. Assistance may involve law enforcement, humanitarian aid, and disaster relief. Today I'll talk about how we promote gender equality in our organization, but also during operations. Key to successful operations are the people we recruit and employ. I need good people, period. I don't really care who you are, where you come from. I do care that you are competent and motivated. Besides being able to do the work we are paid for, our troops must also embrace the values that society holds dear. People who do not subscribe to equality between men and women, who do not care about tolerance and diversity, will not find a place within our ranks. Having said all this, I do believe there are differences between men and women, and I'm convinced we can use these kind of differences to our advantage. Women simply play an essential role, for instance, during the reconstruction, the restoration, and the sustainment in peace and security. Our experiences from deployments in Afghanistan, Iraq, and Mali, and other countries have underlined the instrumental value of the involvement of women and gender equality in a broader sense. Let me give you three examples of my experiences during my operations, for instance, in Iraq. Firstly, it proved of the utmost importance to have female military in our team while conducting, for instance, search operations, so they could address the local women and female in a proper way. Secondly, I had an excellent field hospital at hand with a balanced team of men and women, commanded by an outstanding female doctor. She provided the right balance and insights during the various command discussions. And finally, I had the luxury in having a great female interpreter, who just by using her voice managed to get villagers out of an area we were about to raid. And again, this showed me that the most successful operation is the one which not we are firing any bullets at all. Over the years, we have learned that not applying the gender perspective in our operations can and will negatively affect our freedom of movement, our force protection, and hence our ability to create a safe and secure environment. So, including women in our organization is not merely a moral imperative, it is actually essential for our operational effectiveness. Both men and women have different qualities that will, each in different ways, contribute to operational success. Women can perform the same roles, to the same standards, under the similar conditions as men. I don't doubt about this. But like the Force Commander UNIFIL already told, women in armed forces also have a role model to play for girls and women elsewhere. As such, they are drivers for change. And their presence can inspire local women and girls to the utmost. However, recruiting and especially retaining female personnel is not an easy thing to do. Especially nowadays, the economic situation in the Netherlands is not really favorable. Unemployment rate is low, and highly technical skilled workers are hard to come by, and there are shortages in health, IT, and also education. And the salaries in the private sector are considerably higher than anything we can offer. We made, however, some important steps to make it easier for women to enroll. In 2017, the Dutch government agreed with the Minister of Defense that conscription should also apply to women. Although conscription is officially suspended in the Netherlands, it is still an important signal in terms of equality. Also, women are allowed to apply for elite combat forces, like the commandos and the Marines. Our current female participation in Dutch armed forces remains relatively low. It's about 11%. We have, however, good examples of successful women in our armed forces, like we have a female base commander of an air base here in the Netherlands, and of the 23 missions we run, in 3 missions, female officers are in charge. But we know this is not enough. In a way, we hope that new ways of warfare can be an impetus for change in female participation within the armed forces. Whilst new aspects of warfare and technology have been introduced to the armed forces, more opportunities present themselves. For instance, I'm thinking about the current dynamics on information warfare, where the aspects of cyber and hybrids are becoming increasingly important. Women may be better qualified to take up that kind of jobs, ensuring an increase in female participation numbers. I know there are incredible women in the field, for instance, like cybersecurity, in many nations around the world. And this may provide a positive outlook for the future. But even more important than ensuring sufficient number of women in our forces is the question on how to ensure gender awareness and equality in a broader sense. We could also look upon gender in terms of quality, not merely in quantity. Based on operational experiences of our gender advisors in missions like in Afghanistan and Lebanon, we are currently focusing to be a leading contributor in international training on gender. I have 3 examples for you. First of all, within the UN, the retired Dutch Major General Kammaert is in the lead of the UN Female Military Officers course. Of course, what Ella told you about. It's an all-female course, and this course directly responds to the UN's push for an increase in the amount of women in peacekeeping operations, focusing on force effectiveness. In addition to this, the Dutch Ministry of Defense also provides training capacity to the UN Military Gender Advisors course. This is a pre-deployment course for UN gender advisors and supports the integration of the gender perspective in the UN Staff Officers course. Together with Spain, we have also developed a comprehensive approach to gender in operations. This course is quite unique in its kind and underlines the relevance of gender in the total military context. It also links gender to concepts like protection of civilians, sexual gender-based violence, and the comprehensive approach. What else can we do? Besides on focusing in the international arena on training, we also focus on our own organization. We want to ensure that everyone, male or female, understands and values the gender equality concept and applies this in a day-to-day work, whether you are in the Netherlands or abroad. Our broader approach to gender has been further detailed to our Defense Action Plan 1325 and in the subsequent Defense Implementation Plan. And that is currently being drafted. In this implementation plan, we focus on 3 lines of effort. First, gender at home, to promote gender awareness, and thereby contributing also to situational awareness and cultural awareness, and to embed this in our organization. Second, gender in operations. In other words, besides using education and training, also exploring additional ways to integrate the topic within the Dutch Armed Forces. And third, gender personnel, to embed gender-dedicated staff throughout the organization to oversee the gender perspective, and that is to be considered in the day-to-day processes and activities. In the end, as an organization, we must always strive to be more professional and more effective today compared to yesterday. This also applies to the gender equality perspective. Gender is not merely a niche, it's something of us all, like Deirdre and Ella already told us. To conclude, steps have been taken, but we have still a lot of work to do. For me, it's evident that the gender equality perspective is crucial to mission success. It is clear that we have to increase our efforts to incorporate this in our mindset and also our organizational culture. This will also be key to eventually increase the participation of women in armed forces, particularly during peacekeeping operations in the future. Perhaps that changing requirements within our society and in the nature of warfare will even speed up the participation of females in peacekeeping operations. Thank you very much.